Hello?
Yes, hi. I'm calling from the library. I'd like to make an order, please.
Okay, what would you like?
Shh, I need you to whisper. I'm at the library.
What
Quiet,
do you want?
Please.
Okay, I'm sorry about that.
Sir, please whisper. I'd like to make an order.
Okay, what would you like?
Shh, do not whisper.
Quiet!
Sorry.
Sir, please, just whisper. What type of fish do you have?
Tuna, we have a great tuna.
Sir, you're too loud. She's coming over.
I'm sorry. God,
give me that phone.
I'm sorry.
Hello.
This is Ethel Mertz, the librarian.
Okay.
Can you please keep it down, sir? Do you understand?
Yeah.
Do you know how to whisper, jackass?
Yeah, I know when you whisper it.
Okay, shh. Even now, you're yelling.
I'm not yelling.
I'm going to put this gentleman back on the phone, but I want you to be quiet, okay?
Hello?
Okay, what would you like?
What are your chicken dishes?
Chicken?
Yes.
You know, we have chicken salad.
Can you speak up? I can't hear you. You're whispering.
I'm whispering. That's what you told me, to whisper it.
I can hear you!
I'm sorry.
Sir, you're too loud.
Yeah, but... You know what? You guys are a bunch of assholes.
I need you to whisper, sir. She's gonna hear you.
Don't make me come over there, goddammit!
Tell the bitch to shut up!
Oh no, you can't do that! I'm gonna get in trouble!
Fuck you!
Hi, Richard Lewis is an old friend of the show. And he is a comedian. He's on Curb Your Enthusiasm. And there he is. There's Richard Lewis.
There he is!
Oh.
You know, I see him on Curb Your Enthusiasm all the time. One of my favorite shows.
I don't watch Curb Your Enthusiasm, but Robin does.
Yeah.
You cunt.
You can't say that. Oh, you can say that.
It won't make any difference here.
Wish Fred.
Hey. Good to see you, man.
Hey, Richard.
So, Artie Lang.
Yeah.
Can I walk around here?
Do whatever you want.
It's like a nightclub. This is unfucking believable.
Go ahead. Walk around, too. Go ahead.
You know what you need in life? Balance.
Yes.
When I heard you say you needed balance... This is I know you're 25, 30 years.
Right. You
have
need
you
balance.
Hey, turn that. What is this? What is this big van shit in my fucking head?
Yeah, turn that off. Go ahead. Let the guy
Where's
talk.
Artie Lang? I'll tell you something right now, you motherfucker. When you say that you saw me at Carnegie Hall and then you saw these specials and then you wanted to be a comic
right.
And then I hear you were fucking bullshitting in here.
What?
Oh, he's still working?
I didn't say that.
Don't try to be
I
a,
did
don't
not
be a
say
fucking
that.
Asshole. Have a little
Fred
fucking...
Fred said that.
Oh,
Fred
you did?
Said that. Yeah.
Oh, Fred. No, Fred deserves to say it.
No,
I thought it was
though.
You, you cunt.
How are you? Good to see you.
I feel great. Congratulations on every, you know.
Richard, what is with the Nehru jacket?
Richard just shook my hand, so I've got to put some gel on it.
Oh, babe, I need some gel, too, because I touch my own fucking hand.
Yeah, I don't want to do that.
I knew Fred's impression of me would get me in
Fred,
trouble.
Fred, was that really you,
Richard,
you cocksucker? I knew it would be you.
Richard,
actually, I like that.
Where do I sit? Here on a couch?
Sit down.
It's like the Tonight Show?
Richard.
What the fuck is this?
Are you... Do you have OCD? My spies out there tell me you do have it, right?
No, I'm obsessive compulsive and anal retentive.
No, but I'm being serious. You checked your sunglasses like 20 times in the mirror to see how you looked. Is that a
compulsive? No, it wasn't. No.
Why did you check?
You want to know?
Yeah.
Because I had a cut cornea last week and a hernia a month ago, and I'm just feeling everything hurts.
Oh,
you ever have a hernia, by the way?
I've never had one. No, I hear they're very painful.
Well, if you don't know what it is, I had a gig in a concert in Florida, and I took a shower, and just a half hour before the gig, naked, looking in the mirror, you know, because I have OCD.
Right.
And a fucking grapefruit, it looked like a grapefruit, came out of my groin, a bump. I thought I had cancer.
Oh, my God.
So I went on stage, and I told the audience that I'm dying of cancer, and this is my last, I swear to God. And I said, you need to let, because I'm dying of cancer. Right. You don't know if it's a lump growing out of your fucking balls.
Oh, it's scary. And is it painful?
Unbelievably painful. So they laughed. It was the greatest concert in my life. If I just touched my forehead and I scratched like a mosquito, they fucking stood up and applauded.
In other words, this was reality coming off on the stage and people were laughing. Meanwhile, you're worried out of your brain.
And I had to fly all the way back from Florida thinking I was dying. And then when I found out it was a hernia.
Well, you're a hypochondriac, right?
Huge.
Yeah. And so you go to the doctor. Did you have 22 MRIs? Is that true?
Wait, for the hernia? No.
Yeah. Someone told me you were so paranoid.
Wait,
did Fred say that?
You kind of.
Did you have 22 MRIs recently?
I've had them probably within the year.
An MRI is a very severe thing.
You're going to die of the radiation.
Yeah, your brain is glowing.
No, I walk around them. I don't go in them.
Why do you have so many MRIs?
You know, listen. I'm, you know, I hit 60, man, and everything. Every time I feel a fucking, even if it's like a headache, I think it's a tumor.
Well, you look and you.
But nothing's wrong with you. Nothing's happened.
No, I just had a physical.
Yeah.
And they say all right, but you don't know what what's going on inside your stomach, your spleen, or your balls.
Are you afraid of dying?
No.
You're just afraid of getting sick.
Yeah, I hate being sick.
I remember years ago when you were on the show. Yeah. You were in one time.
I was on a million times. It like I was on once.
No, I don't mean it that way. Yeah. I don't mean it that way.
Well, you got too big. You got too big times. You wouldn't come on.
Oh, bullshit.
There was a time you
were
on.
Can I just set the record straight?
Go ahead.
I admit, because I had sent you, thanks for the Christmas card, by the way. It was a great card.
You're welcome.
Your fiance.
I love that
beautiful.
Card. Yeah.
Thank you.
Listen, the bottom line is, you know, after like 20 years, when we used to sit down with Gilbert and Bells and I are touring now. Great guy. Loves you, you know. And Kinison, I sent you a Kinison tape.
Right. Thank you.
But that was when we were sitting reading the paper and just bullshitting. That's when I was like, that's when I was really a good guest. But when you change a little bit in the format, I wasn't a good guest. I'd be the first to admit
You're
it.
You're a very good guest.
No. When I had to smell panties, it wasn't my thing.
Well, listen, I love you. I think you're one of the funniest guys around. There's no question about it. In fact, weren't you recently named one of the top 50 comedians of all time?
I don't know. Who knows? That's all a list.
That's a major
Comedy
list.
Central.
I'm just in town warming up for gigs, not concerts.
Comedy Central named Richard one of the top 50 stand-up comedians of all time. Is that a great thing to you when you're named that? You don't care?
Do you get a call from your agent or...
No, they don't give a fuck. Are you crazy?
Do you hate
They don't give a fuck about that shit.
My impression of you was that you, and be honest with me, right. That you always
I just want to fuck Artie Lang on the pilot. That's the stupid. Artie, you're kidding, right?
What?
Is that the show? Who what? Wants to fuck Artie Lang?
Yeah, it is.
All right, good luck with it. I'm sure it's going to have a long run. You're lucky to get a fucking chimp to want to fuck you.
Wow. Well, I'm his biggest fan.
I know. Richard.
You're not my biggest fan, you fucking liar. How do you tolerate this guy?
You know a
bullshit?
Guy bigger than me?
You're such a bullshit. You're a star now, but don't bullshit so much.
I'm a star.
He can smell bullshit. Rob and him can smell bullshit a mile away.
Has carried away with himself? Is that the problem?
Carried away with himself?
Yeah.
He's beyond carried away.
Really? Is that the word in the comedy industry?
Huge.
I had the first conversation with this guy that lasted more than 10 seconds outside.
It was more than 10 seconds, and you carried away with yourself and you're an egomaniac.
I quoted jokes of his from 20 years ago that I liked, and now he's giving me this shit.
And then you're blaming Fred for reaming me. It was you.
Fred did it.
Bullshit.
Answer a question for me.
And who wants to fuck out of your line?
I want you to be honest with me.
Sure.
Is my girlfriend.
I always got the impression with your career.
Right.
That you really hated doing stand-up comedy.
Love it more than anything.
Now.
Yeah, now.
Not then. I'm talking about...
I was an active drunk, I was frenzied.
Are we back again with the active drunk? Now, you really...
Oh, yeah, I remember that. 14 years ago, you wanted to pour champagne in my ass so I would drink.
No, you know, you're a funny guy. You know, Richard...
I appreciate
Richard
that.
Wrote
and
a
you're
book.
A hell of a nice guy.
No, Richard wrote a book.
It's coming out again, yeah.
What do you mean again?
I did more writing about it after 14 years. I look back on it. I know Artie can really relate to this.
Now, how bad a drunk were you?
No, wait a second. Before you get to that, we're going to go there, but you're reissuing a book that you wrote already.
No, it's a reissue because I did more writing.
You wrote a forward, yeah.
You wrote a forward.
I did more than that.
What did you do?
Huh?
What do you mean you did more than that?
I balanced it on my nose.
You balanced the book on your nose.
Right. No, I reflected on after 14 years without drugs and alcohol.
What drugs were you on?
Every drug except heroin.
Oh, stop it,
Now, the
Richard.
Story is changing. Is this in the original book, you said you used to sip champagne.
And he had a champagne problem.
I had a funnel in my ass.
You had a champagne problem.
No, you said that. You were very funny. No,
you did.
I drank everything.
No, hold it. Let me tell you what I read in your book. You became very concerned about your life.
Right, look at the look in your fucking... I wish... Oh, it's on TV, too. Yeah. Look at the fucking... I love your eyes, man. You lie so great. I'm not lying.
If I'm lying, you tell me, okay? I'm gonna tell my audience what you wrote in your book.
All right, sure.
The gist was that you came clean and said that you had a problem with alcohol.
Right.
The problem with alcohol was you became alarmed. You were drinking some glasses of champagne, and you fell asleep at a movie screening.
Yeah, a couple of flutes a night.
What was the movie?
It's one sentence in a fucking 500-page...
What was the movie you fell asleep during?
Tom Hanks' movie with the baseball team.
Yeah, everybody fell asleep in that movie.
We all have a problem.
You were not the only one who fell asleep in that movie,
by
the way.
Because I had,
that was no reason to go to rehab.
All right, but you became concerned you would drink a glass...
That wasn't the reason I went I was a drunk for 20 years.
You even described that you had once drank a whole bottle of champagne.
Right. All by yourself.
Yeah.
You're now, trying to trivialize a drunk's life. Fine. I don't give a shit.
No, but I'm saying you really...
We just are saying you were no Artie Lang.
Now in the new book...
What do you want me to, like, start boasting about better stuff? No. Hey, crystal meth. Is that...
But you never... You did
crystal meth. Am I on your A-list now?
But you never spoke about crystal meth in the original book.
I didn't?
No, you didn't talk about cocaine.
I blame the editor. Oh, I did. I bottomed out on crystal meth and coke.
You did?
Yeah.
You never told me that.
You only read the index.
You told me champagne you had a problem with.
Crystal meth? We never heard that.
Where'd you grow up in the South?
Oh, wait. Did I say crystal meth? Oh, wait a minute. I got a there's other problems getting old until your fucking brain goes.
Did you
what's
ever...
What's that coke? What's the other... It's not coke. It's the...
speed? You mean like...
No, not speed.
Heroin?
What?
No, not heroin.
Crack?
No, crystal meth.
Crystal meth you did.
No, it wasn't crystal meth.
What was
free
it?
Freebasing
you. No, it was, what
it's,
were you?
It's like it's
snipping
coke.
Glue?
No, it's coke, but it's a little, it's cut.
Crack.
No.
What did you do? Tell everyone what you did.
Freebase?
No, I didn't have a freebase. It was any kind of liquor, and the champagne only at bar mitzvahs and weddings. But what's that?
What
what's
liquor?
That,
you
that,
can't
what
even.
Stuff?
What stuff?
No, you snort it. It's not. It's
amyl nitrate for
no,
your
it's
asshole.
Cocaine. It's like cocaine. I can't think of the name. I'm blanking.
Oxycodone?
No. That's all.
It sounds exactly.
What are you talking about? Oxycodone's only for when you get
Poppers?
Your teeth cleaned.
Whippets.
I gotta slow the conversation.
Yeah, really. Calm down.
It's too much going on here.
It's not my fault.
No, it doesn't.
I'm trying
right.
to guess the drugs.
Have you rewatched A League of Their Own sober since? did you ever see the movie after you finished?
Actually, I don't think I did.
Okay, so what you
just a bad memory.
I wasn't trying to be funny or facetious with you, but Richard Lewis, the comedian, wrote a book, and I thought that you were saying that you had a problem because you would drink a couple of glasses of champagne.
I didn't read the book, Howard.
I didn't. This is what you told me.
What's the name of that drug? I can't think of that drug. Artie, what's that drug you do? It's like coke, but it's not.
I know. Well,
it's a step up from coke.
It is.
What is it?
Well, I'm trying to think
called crack.
No,
not crack,
because
you smoke crack.
No,
you snort this, you said?
I snorted it.
Are you saying methamphetamine?
Yeah, but it's... I can't think of the name of it.
You mean you were a drug addict and you don't know what you did?
I was a drug addict, yeah.
Now you're
painting... I abused prescription drugs, too.
All right, you're painting...
What's the difference? It's 14 years ago.
Huh? Adderall?
No.
All right.
Isn't that a snake?
You're painting a different picture now of your addiction.
You didn't read the whole book. No, I wrote about all the drugs.
We went by what you said. You told us it was a champagne problem.
Yeah, and I thought that was girly.
I know you did.
I did. I was
you
like,
have 5 bottles of champagne for the Today Show. It's a problem.
You had 5 bottles of champagne before
many days.
The problem is you have to pee every minute.
You're telling me
you went on the Today Show.
No, watching it at home, I would drink.
Five bottles.
Drink all day long. Someday, not every day, but when I wanted to get hammered, I drink all day long.
Wow.
And then what would happen? You would call Maria Melito.
Who's Maria Melito?
Maria Melito.
Disc jockey?
Yeah, he used to call her on the phone.
He did?
The radio.
You know, you guys have all this cause and effect shit. You know, I wasn't doing it all the time. I just, when I got hammered, I couldn't stop.
All right.
But I knew when not to drink. Then I quit stand-up for 3 years because I knew I'd blow my career, so I said, fuck it.
So, okay. So this is a serious addiction. I didn't realize it was that serious.
Yeah.
You kind of painted a trivial addiction
in
the past. Yeah, you really
did. Reread the book. It's coming out.
All right. So the book is coming out, and you've written a new foreword for it.
And afterwards.
During the time that you used to do your writing in the Four Seasons restaurant?
I drank whenever I wanted to drink, but that was, sometimes you can come up with, like when they say rock guys, come up with a great lick.
Uh-huh.
But I know enough, we all know enough rock guys, if they have a drug problem, that they can come up with the same licks, if not better, if they're not fucking
right.
Loaded. That's all.
And but, now you...
Look,
you...
I don't preach. I don't give a shit. My life, I should be dead. Now I'm not. I'm here with you. That's all.
I can't believe this.
Deal.
Hit it very well, I guess, is what we're saying, because we never really knew you were
I wasn't always drunk when I did your show. I did your show a million times.
But you were always one of these guys. Took care of himself. You were in the gym working out.
You were punctual.
I mean,
you were responsible.
No, you were a good drug
guy. Yeah, when I had days off. I was a good drug.
Now, you were always a bachelor. You were very anti-marriage. You never, you were a playboy in a sense.
Well, probably.
Right. And now I hear you're married.
You got married?
I got married about 3 years ago, yeah.
Wow.
I met a woman about 10 years ago, and I said, this is it, man. It's either now or never. So I have no children.
Right.
I didn't want to have any children. All I wanted to do was make people laugh.
Would you be a horrible father?
I'd be the worst father of all time.
You're still not having children.
Because
no, I met my wife when she was like 42, and now, you know, it's too dangerous. You know, a turkey will come out or something.
You think your wife would give birth to a turkey?
Well, after 49, 50, 51, then it's too late.
Right. Sal, why are you interrupting me? I'm trying to interview somebody.
I apologize, Howard.
Really?
I remember, because I just want to confirm what you said. I remember clear as day when you interviewed him about the champagne addiction.
Yes.
Back then, he didn't deny it. He didn't talk about drugs or hard liquor.
Yeah.
Well, that's my point. So I think, personally, adding pages to the book and everything else, I think this is some gibberish. I think this is a bunch of bullshit. He's trying to come off as an edgier guy because he would have admitted it back then.
He said that if we read the whole book, we would have seen that.
No.
But why are you interrupting me?
Because...
Get out of here.
Get him out of here. I'm getting really angry.
Yeah, get him.
That's how a lot of people get around.
What? Lou was telling me he was doing the research. Do you know how many pages have been added to the book?
How many?
4.5.
4.5 pages?
Wow.
Yeah, 4.5 pages of bullshit. That's what that's my point. I mean, this guy's trying to come off. I like Richard Lewis, but he's trying to come off edgy.
You do?
Because if
you doesn't sound that way, you fucking idiot.
I love you on Curb. That's about it. But the thing is,
get him out of here.
Please leave.
Okay.
So
how is that to talk to a guest?
You're coming in my guest. You're insulting.
No, I love the guy. I'm trying to say.
I don't want your fucking love.
He doesn't want your love.
The point that I'm trying to make, Howard, please, for a second.
No.
I heard it. I'm trying to be edgier. I wasn't a member of Kiss or Motley Crue.
Who sent you in here?
What the fuck is this guy? A messenger from hell?
It's exactly what he is.
Really?
But those 4.5 pages must be dynamite.
No. It's a reissue. I wrote an afterward. That's it. I'm not making anything up. But the drug thing was all in the book.
Okay. All right. Everyone.
And I bottomed on cocaine for 4 days. I holed up. I lost about 15 pounds. And I went to the ER and I was almost died.
And you went to a rehab.
Yeah, but I bolted from the rehab.
You bolted?
Yeah.
Well, so how did you kick the drugs? On your own?
Yeah, I bolted because I was too embarrassed.
You're a sensible guy.
No, people said there's Richard Lewis. I was embarrassed.
You were. Why were you embarrassed?
Well, people have a lot of shame when you know, hey, there's Richard Lewis, he's a drug addict. I just couldn't take it.
You were ashamed of that.
Yeah.
So when you had to stand up, you'd say, hi, I'm Richard Lewis,
I'm a recovering drug addict alcoholic.
Wow.
But now you go around, you do help other people, right?
Yeah.
You do. What do? You lecture at rehab centers and things?
No, I just call people. I meet people with drugs.
You're a sponsor? You're an AA guy and you sponsor people?
There's a lot of different ways I do.
You help people.
Why not?
All right.
I'd like to help Artie, but he's I hope he's on a lost cause.
Right. So you think he's a guy?
Who's this guy? Who's Marley's ghost son who just fucking walked in here with the chain?
I knew
aggravated the shit out of me.
Right.
This guy.
I know. Get it out.
I'm here to see you guys. Now,
that's
all of a sudden,
Sal the stockbroker.
I don't give a fuck who he is. You know, I know you for 26 years. I don't need some strange guy to fucking judge me on your show.
Absolutely.
When I did your show, he was in second grade making fucking blocks.
You know what he is, Richard? He's a fan. That's right.
No, he didn't sound like a fan.
He used to sit and listen to all of us on the show.
That's fucking Jack Ruby's nephew. That's who he was.
I'm sorry. I know that can throw you. I know.
Well, I don't like people fucking judging me who I don't know. If he knows me, then I can. Don't you think?
Yes.
If I like the guy, he can say, you piece of shit. I go, fine, then you're a piece of shit, and we can shake hands and go out.
I'm happy you're here. I'm appreciative that you come and do my show, and he walked in and ruined the moment. Let me talk to you about
something. We were in the middle of a conversation.
Yeah, I'm trying to have a conversation. People walk in here all the time. They interrupt my conversation. I'm trying to have a conversation. You see how offended I am?
Look how quiet I am. I'm a different man.
All right, listen to
me. You used to call me a plug machine. You used to plug me.
Sal, why are you back?
Where are you coming in here for?
Will just said you want me here.
No, I don't want you. You offended. Apologize to Richard right now.
No, he doesn't.
No. Listen, apologize.
Have a good career.
I do apologize, and you are a legend on the show. The only...
All right, thank you.
Goodbye.
Good. The only thing.
He's going to come in here and open up with a fucking machine gun one day.
Right. He's a
nut. We all think that, actually.
He's going through a bad marriage.
Is he really?
Yeah. That's the problem.
See, that's the thing. I waited. I knew I was a fucked up husband. Would have been a fucked up husband. I waited till I was ready.
So you are a good husband now? You're a
great fucking husband.
Oh, really?
You had a lot of beautiful women.
I still do. I have a beautiful wife.
I'm not talking about that. Oh. I'm saying you had a lot of beautiful women in the past. It must have been hard to settle down and finally sort of grow up and say, you know what? This is a good thing. I'm going to stick with this.
It all depends. In France, I'd have a million affairs. It's different. It's also, you know, a lot of guys cheat, have hookers, get happy endings. You know what? It's what makes you happy, you know, when you want to wake. I would never cheat on my wife.
But do you still look? I mean, do you still sometimes fantasize?
Fucking A.
Yeah, you do. It's hard, right?
It's impossible not to. I'm a fucking, you know.
You're a man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But jerking off and fantasizing is not the same.
Do you still jerk off?
Fucking A.
You do?
I love it.
You know, I haven't jerked off since July.
You're kidding me.
Get out of here.
What is this? What, for Lent? You get
no. We counted it up the other day.
I figured it out. Not this was the other
what,
day.
What, you save up? Are you, is your no. dick I'm harder and you have better cum when you when you
I'm
when
having
you
a good sex
up?
Life. I'm really happy.
Does it really help you sexually if you save up sperm? I don't think, I think that's a fantasy.
I feel like whenever I'm horny, I give it to my woman.
That's 7 months.
7 months?
Wait, yeah. Heaven.
Wow.
I'm proud.
He doesn't even want to have a bachelor party, we determine the
Do you realize the last time I didn't jerk off for 7 months was when I was 7 months old?
That's right.
but I, they let people in Gitmo jerk off.
Did you have a, I know, did you have a bachelor party?
No.
No.
No one can do it. I wanted no guests at the wedding, no bachelor party.
Oh, so how did you do it?
I just went in front of a, you know, some spiritual cat and got married. I didn't want anyone to know.
Was your really? Wife upset that
no, she didn't
have
want
a
to. Wedding? She was married a long
she
time.
She was embarrassed too.
She was too hip. She was no. Oh, she, embarrassed.
Oh my God, Robin!
You were both embarrassed.
Launching
to be married?
No, we didn't want anyone to know. I actually did it. I don't know if she's listening. I didn't want any. I wanted to minimize damage control if it didn't work out. Because I was a womanizer, and it was a consensual woman. I got married at 56 years old. I had a lot of, you know, I fucked a lot. My penis was tired.
Right.
So I didn't want to, you know, I said, this is it. I, you know, and I love her, and I just want to make love to my wife, and this is it. But I didn't, if it didn't work out, if she left me.
And your wife.
For a young old man, I didn't want to have everyone be all over the fucking news. So I tried to sneak in the marriage without anyone knowing.
Yeah, very few people know about it. When, did you reveal to your wife early on your champagne problem, that you can't sip the champagne?
Yeah, when do you tell a girl?
Yeah, when do you tell her you can't have champagne?
Don't come near me midnight New Year's. Yeah.
Does your wife drink? Is she allowed to drink?
She can drink. She can do anything she wants. Right. She's not a heavy druggie, but
no, but when you go to
a joint, she can drink.
When you go to a restaurant with her, she has drinks,
well,
and you can handle it?
We go out.
You don't look and go,
I just can't go to parties where people are doing, you know, junk and coke. Then I get nervous.
But
you
can't.
She's not into that.
You
anyway.
Can't have a glass of wine with dinner?
No, I'm an alcoholic.
Okay. And it's not hard to watch her have a glass of wine?
Huh? No. Okay. I just, as long as she sprays it in my face.
So she never saw you abuse champagne?
No, she's never saw me abuse. Right.
But
this champagne
know?
Shit is so, you know, you
did
can't.
Did you snort
what?
Champagne?
How did you get into this champagne shit?
I read your book.
You read one page.
You got drunk on champagne.
I said I love champagne, but I had bottles of it at a time.
At the screening of a boring movie, you passed out.
That was one sentence, you fucking mental case.
That's a sign.
Artie, let me tell you something. You're letting me down big time, Artie.
I want comics this weekend. See, I'm 14th Street.
I want
it's a great
to,
club comics. Yeah.
I should give you a plug here right now.
You know, I might tour with Peter Frampton. You love Frampton, don't you?
Frampton's
Belzer
good.
And I and
that'll
Espen.
Be fun.
What a show!
Yeah, no, I don't plug anymore, but I am here.
Richard Lewis
tomorrow.
Tomorrow night and Saturday night at Comics in
beautiful
Manhattan.
Venue. By
for
the
tickets,
way.
Go to comicsnewyork.com. comix. And Richard's book, The Other Great Depression, will be reissued on March 17th with a new afterword. And Richard's documentary, Richard Lewis Naked, is available at richardlewisnaked.com.
Well, Michelle Marks made that filmmaker, not me.
Let me get to something serious with you. Yeah. You.
I will say anything you want. When people interrupt us, it makes me look fucking bad in front of you. Then you start yelling at me. That's
okay.
What happens.
So let me ask you. Answer
anything
I'm
you want.
I'm going to give you time to answer this.
I'm going to shut up.
No, I doubt that.
I want
your
you.
Ego won't allow it.
I won't. I won't minimize your answer to this. I want a serious answer. Now, this alcohol, this depression.
Oh, no.
No. Shh.
All right,
this
I'm
is
listening.
Your book. Okay. Obviously, there were reasons for this depression. Now, I interviewed you a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
All right. Put your glasses back on. You look better with them on. All right. Listen to me.
You've always been my stylist, yeah, haven't you?
Put those back on.
And your head looks a little better, shorter than style, by the way.
Thank you. You look good, too. Answer this question for me.
Are you going to fuck Artie Lang on the pilot?
Yes.
Why don't you just say, who wants to fuck Artie Lang, you cunt? Make it a double header hit.
It's not my idea.
Oh, okay. I'm Howard's
all right.
Talking.
All right. Are you the funny man who can't be serious?
You want to get serious.
All right, here's what I'm asking you.
Yeah, go on.
Okay. So, I remember a couple of years ago I was interviewing you.
All right.
And your mother called in.
Oh, yes.
Right.
And you had a very strange reaction.
She's dead now, so go easy.
Yeah, okay, so listen to me. So, you had a strange reaction. While I was interviewing, your mother was on the phone. You freaked out so badly that you left the studio.
You were telling him to hang up. I remember that.
And you went into a bathroom
at
K-Rock, and you started to sweat, and you really had some reaction.
Now, a little breakdown.
At first, I thought it was a bit, and I still sort of thought that. But Gary said, look, there was no bit. The guy was freaking out. What was the deal with you? Your mother has since passed away. I'm sorry to hear that. I didn't know that. When did she pass away?
99. Yeah.
What went on? What went down between you and mother?
I was afraid, since I couldn't handle you, I was afraid that my mother would have a nervous breakdown on the phone with you, so I freaked.
No, you didn't like your mother.
Well, we didn't get along.
Why? What went on there? Well, now you can talk about it.
Well, it's an old joke, but it's true. When I got the Tonight Show, when Artie was one,
yeah,
Mr. Big Shot.
You were on with Johnny Carson?
And I said, Mother, I'm on the Tonight Show. And she said to me, who else is on?
Oh, my God.
So that started the whole ball rolling. Then I went right to the Rainbow and got hammered.
So she was a bad mother?
Not a bad mother. She just didn't understand my humor, and she bugged me.
Didn't like your humor? She didn't think you were funny?
She wasn't my fucking target market. She was, you know, a parent from Romania and Russia.
But
do you think
asking,
she fucking knows who Procol Harum is? You know.
Did you feel that your mother never really knew you?
I didn't give a fuck if she knew me.
Yes, you did.
No.
You're telling me your mother didn't fill the needs that you had. Is that true?
A little bit, Howard. You're right about
that. No. Come on. What happened with you and
this
your mother?
Therapy thing. You know, I think we can actually be friends now. And I always wanted to be friends with you because you have more balance in your life. Now,
I don't want to be friends with you.
You listen don't. Why not? We'd have a great time.
I would be happy.
I would love to take you and your fiance. And you love my wife.
Where is your wife? Is she in New York?
She'll be in a couple of days.
Well, could give me a call in a couple of days, and we'll go out to dinner.
Yeah. You guys,
know
Sal and his wife.
1-800-Cirrus. Like I'm really gonna get you.
I'm gonna give you the number.
Yeah. After 25 years, I should be able to at least email you and ask you how you are.
1-89-ASSHOLE.
I would give you my email, but the problem is I'm afraid you'll abuse it.
You want to repeat that punch, that ad lib, Artie?
1-89-ASSHOLE.
That's fun. Can I get the bootleg of that?
but that's our actual number. I'm not making that up like some hack.
So you hated your relationship with your mother. Is that correct?
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah. Can you describe that to me? I don't understand
what went
wrong.
She didn't get me, and she didn't understand anything about me. So when you're a baby, I guess, I don't know I don't even know why we're even alive.
Right.
It's a miracle to me. I'm not a religious guy, but it's a miracle that I'm even here talking to you and hearing Artie's ad-libs. To me, that's a fucking miracle.
He's afraid you'd abuse the email like champagne.
That's funny, too. Put that on the fucking pilot when you do Who Wants to Fuck Artie Lang, you cunt.
Richard, I want to come see you and Peter Frampton, but I have tickets for Bobby Slayton and Journey.
You are...
Bobby's very funny.
You got this TV show now. It's...
Everyone says, you know, it happens to be a cult show all over the world, and you've been ragging on it.
He doesn't even see it.
I watched it once, and I didn't like it.
Well, that's fair enough.
And I'm happy you're on it. I know people love Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Sal said he loves Curb.
Yeah. Now, you were... camp friend. You went to summer camp with Larry David, right? The creator of Curb Your Enthusiasm.
At 12, and then I hated his guts. He hated my guts, and then I met him at the improv where we started, and we became best friends.
Summer camp, you hated each other.
Hate.
Why?
We had fist fights. He was a fucking asshole, I was an asshole.
You were both assholes.
Yeah.
And then later on in life, you became friends when
best
you became
best friends,
comics.
And then one day I looked in his eyes, 13 years later, I said, you look very familiar, like Roman Polanski kind of time.
Right.
And I said, and we retraced our childhood, and when we realized we were the same fucking assholes at 12, we freaked out. It was like a billion to one shot.
He put you on the show, and then he did you the biggest favor in the world. He made your television girlfriend, Tia Carrera, is that correct?
Boy, she's something.
And the critics were critical of this. They said...
Why?
They said Richard Lewis could never get Tia Carrera in real life.
I didn't read that fucking article.
Yes, and they said...
that fucking review.
No, they said it's unrealistic that Richard Lewis could be with Tia Carrera. Did you know that?
You know something? I don't know. That's funny, but when I did show up on the set with Tia, know what she said to me?
What?
My career's over. I swear to God.
I think the Richard Lewis on Hiller and Diller, that guy.
Do you know Asian American?
Let me tell you something. You are on fire tonight, Artie. Yes, you better do some writing.
I'm going to read to you from the Salt Lake City... What is it called?
Well, who cares about that?
Weekly. Salt Lake City Weekly. In what universe...
Yeah, they love Jews in Utah.
Richard Lewis dating Tia Carrera?
What universe would Richard Lewis be dating Tia Carrera?
So some writer wants to, you know, go out with her, and he's jealous.
Did you make out with her in the show?
Unfortunately, no.
No.
Larry doesn't write love scenes for me.
I thought he was doing you such a brotherly favor. Like, he says, hey, you want to make out with Tia Carrera? We'll get her to be your girlfriend, and I'll write love scenes.
Let me ask you a question. My wife says this every time. Because I've had... I've made out and had affairs on sets before, right?
Sure.
And she's right. And she, my wife's very hip. She was in a record business her whole life.
Okay.
She says, don't fucking tell me that when you're kissing and humping and don't give me this camera angle shit. She's right.
Yeah, you do get excited.
It's unbelievable.
Of course you do.
It's fucking the great. It's when I did that show with Jamie Lee Curtis, I prayed for a makeout scene.
Did you ever hook up with Jamie Lee Curtis? Did the two of you ever become?
Because Chris Guest and I were friends, and I never would go out with a married woman.
You didn't break the code, huh?
Never break that code, man.
You were sexually attracted though to Jamie Lee when you did that TV show.
I'm attracted to every beautiful woman.
It was a good TV show.
To this day,
I loved that show.
4 years, it was a good run.
I loved it. I loved it. Yeah.
I do have one more from the Canadian National Post, just because it's so stupid. They really are angry with you. In other news, Carrera signed up to play Richard Lewis's girlfriend on Curb Your Enthusiasm. Richard Lewis, he's what, 160?
Oh.
No, you're kidding me.
That's the Canadian National Post.
He looks younger than ever.
It might be a typo. It's just 60.
What is everyone attacking Richard for?
First of all, I could give a fuck. You know, I have... How much...
What is that?
Can you imagine I care? After 38 years in the business with 8 billion reviews...
Did you make a lot of money in this business?
Of course.
You did?
Yeah.
Are you a multimillionaire?
I probably.
Did you sign a prenup with your wife?
No, I don't need to do that.
What?
Huh?
You don't have a prenup?
I don't think so. So this is where we get into trouble. This is where we get into trouble. This is when you start digging. You go into the penis, inside my brain, and you want to get really personal shit that my lawyers won't allow me to discuss.
No, I'm really curious. Did you and your wife sit down
at this point in my life, if I would have gotten married at 30 and 40, absolutely I would have.
You're saying at this point
I'm so in love with my wife. You know, I actually go on stage. Like this weekend, I'll go on stage because I know I'm going to make her life better.
You know what? I know a guy who's just like you. He said the same thing on the show. He's Paul McCartney.
Oh, don't even say that.
He said, I'm an older guy. I don't need a prenup. I'm in love. And he told me that.
He didn't say that. He said, I believe in the whole thing.
Yes.
Well, that's that, you know, Sergeant Pepper stuff. I just, at this point in my life, I love Joyce, even though the name sucks.
Joyce, you don't like your wife's name?
I say, you know, how can you say, blow me, Joyce?
You can't. Not good.
You can't. She knows it, too. She says, call me another name.
That's right.
And I can't come up with one. It's so great to see you
Was
here.
It a romantic proposal that you gave your wife?
The worst.
The worst proposal. How did you propose?
First of all, I have a fear of intimacy. We've discussed this over a quarter
years,
of a century.
Yeah.
I had black CD socks. Oh, these are short socks. I had my father's socks up to past my knee,
socks.
Like your grandfather used to wear. Boxer shorts, not facing her. She was like in bed, naked.
Yeah.
And I looked out the window on the third floor of my house, and I went, I guess I have to. That was the proposal.
You said, I guess I have to.
And
because you looked at yourself
in
the mirror.
She knew what you were talking
about.
Yeah,
and she says, all right, fine. It was not exactly, you know, fucking somebody at midnight in a rain, you know, in the Eiffel Tower.
Why were you almost nude when you proposed if it doesn't look
like I'm always in boxer shorts. Like Rodney Jr.
I see.
Always in boxer shorts and black socks. Like a porn, like a Yiddish porn movie.
And when you said to her, I think I have to do it, she didn't think you meant suicide. She knew marriage.
She knew marriage because we were living together for 2 years.
Let's go to Brian. You're on with Richard Lewis.
Oh, here comes. Here comes the attack. Bring the attack dogs on. I give a shit anymore.
All right, Brian, you're on in Philadelphia.
Howard, I think Richard was looking for speedball earlier.
No.
That's heroin and coke. You know.
I don't know.
The dealer came. It looks like cocaine, and I just snorted.
I think you're talking about crystal meth.
That's what it was.
It is.
Crystal meth.
You couldn't even remember what it was.
I can't imagine.
No, I was so wrecked.
You seem so level-headed to me that you would do crystal meth. That is like an unbelievable.
Hey, take this. This is a true story. You ready?
Okay.
I went out with a woman. And I had dinner with Rod Stewart and one of his ex-wives and Ronnie Wood, who's a really good friend of mine.
Oh, okay? Name dropper. Ron Wood of the Rolling Stones.
He's a great artist. I know him for 20 years.
Oh.
It's not neighbor.
Well, now maybe
you don't
can
know
have
everybody.
Wow. Maybe you can have dinner with him.
You're in his book.
I will go to dinner with you. I didn't realize. Okay,
that's right.
On.
See, all the, with one of the Stones.
Now we're on. Bring the Stones.
So guess what? So the dinner, we're in L.A., a restaurant used to call The Dome. It was a great restaurant.
Sure.
Go ahead.
I go there, I make a deal of meet me at the bar with a couple of grams. I go down to the bathroom for 2 hours and never come out.
During dinner with Ron Wood.
Stewart and his ex-wife, Ronnie,
Stewart,
and his wife.
When Ron Wood.
And their managers at the time.
When Ron Wood says, hey, this guy's out of control, you know you're in trouble.
Yeah, Ron Wood wasn't that into him blowing you. I just read his book. You read his book, you're in it, you know.
Ron wasn't a big drug guy?
I think you're in love with me, Artie. What do you think of this theory?
No, maybe. From the back, you look like a bro.
Ron Wood wasn't
That's hilarious.
Ron Wood wasn't
Get rid of this guy.
Crystal meth is a good drug if you need to walk to St. Louis 1 week.
Do you,
which special of mine did you steal that one from?
That's all me, jerk off.
All right, you want me back.
I'll be on my next DVD. That's the opener.
I'll be on your next DVD. You know when I'll be on your next DVD? When Hitler moves to fucking Laurel Canyon. That's when I'll be on your fucking DVD. That's all I got to do. What are you doing today? I'm on Artie Lang's DVD. I'll put a fucking gun in my mouth.
That would be the end of your career.
Babe, why should I be on Artie Lang's anything?
Right.
I wish him the best. He's a star. You made him a star. He's very funny.
Exactly.
People love him.
Right.
Even though he does half my fucking act, I don't give a shit.
He steals a lot of your material.
You know how many comics are on that? You know this. It fucking drives me fucking nuts. I have like 30 hours in my computer. It's all, no one knows what it is. If I came out, people, these comics write books. They put their fucking, they regurgitate their jokes.
Yeah.
What bullshit that is.
Right.
You're knocking me on telling my fucking guts in a book. I don't write one line in a book. When's, Artie, when's your joke book coming out called, Hey, Fuck Me Joke Book?
Mark Cronin's putting that out, not me.
All right.
I love Comedy Central. I might do a show for Comedy Central.
Don't kiss their ass now.
What is wrong with you two? Can't you play nice?
Let's go to Billy.
Carlos Mencia might give you a spot.
Oh.
All
right, Billy, you're on in Boston, Massachusetts. Go ahead.
Hey, Howard, how you doing?
Yeah.
Hey, Louis.
What are you? Yeah, what's your last name?
My last name is Quick.
What is it, Quick?
Listen.
Don't fucking give me this tone.
Are you 59?
What?
What?
Are you 60 yet?
Yeah, he's 60.
Yeah, I just turned 60. Why?
Oh, okay.
I guess we can't date now, huh?
I'm the same age. We're officially old people. Listen, I
That's
followed
funny.
Your career, and I just want to say hi and say that you are one of the most underrated comedians because I think you're brilliant. I'm not kissing your ass. I just wanted to let you know you got a fan out here, and I'm loving this interview. If Robin and Howard would shut up.
Oh, my God.
Oh, come on.
Robin and Artie.
Well, that'll get me back here fast.
If I shut up, how am I going to interview him?
No, not
he
you.
He meant Robin and Artie.
Oh, well.
Robin and Artie.
They, you know, look, now he's going to obsess that you think he's underrated. Why is
Mike,
he underrated?
Mike, you're on the air.
Hey, how many women have you been with, Richard?
Oh, he's
Do you have a tally?
He's been with a ton of them.
Well, you know, I don't know. Who the fuck cares, you know?
It's a lot.
It was consensual. Well, I wasn't a rapist.
You sure?
At what age? Yeah.
Well, I did have a blackout, though, with one woman I went out with for 4 months, and I met her, and she looked familiar, and we went out for 4 months. We were a couple, and I had no recollection.
Really?
Were you a bad boyfriend? I mean, were you abusive? Not in the physical sense, but in the sense that you were emotionally distant, that you would cheat.
I cheated a lot. Almost on everyone, yeah.
You feel bad about that?
Horrible.
Yeah.
But I called the people that I cared about and told them.
Do you think it's because you hate women, you hated your mother, that you were angry with your
it's
mother?
It's like a shrink now, Robin. It's unbelievable.
Yes,
I'm asking you.
I know
angry?
Exactly why I did it.
Why?
My shrink said I was not just a sex addict, I was an affection junkie.
Right.
Because my mother didn't give me the respect I thought I wanted, so I wanted it from every woman I could see.
Do you think that was it?
That is it. I was a womanizer for that reason. I needed everyone. Oh, hear it? Oh, fuck, man. This Vic Damone shit's killing me.
Richard Lewis. Anything but mom.
Jesus, he needs a writer.
I'm tossing out whatever I got here.
Tossing it out. It's coming out of your ass.
Is it true?
Exactly.
Is it true you were so angry with your mother you signed autographs while she was lowered into her grave?
Oh, man.
Is that true?
I'll tell you what I did do, though.
Is that true?
No, that's not true.
I heard that is true.
But I'm a people pleaser. That's one of my problems.
Yes.
And when, during the, look.
During
my
the
when is that going to kick in?
Hey,
let
it.
Me try to finish a thought, you fucking asshole. When, during the burial, these two cats were, you know, it was a very sad moment. I loved it. She tried her best, okay?
Right. Understood.
But when they lowered the casket, this is true. This is how sick people-pleasing can become for an addict.
Right.
I went over to the gravediggers and said, you guys really are doing a fantastic job.
Did you really?
I swear to God.
I believe that.
And then they said, loved you in Robin Hood Men in Tights. So it was like, you know, I'll always feel guilty for thanking the gravediggers.
You did Letterman show a lot. I don't see you on there as much.
Well, who does? So is it, I did it about 70 times.
But what happened between you and Letterman? You
nothing.
Not,
I was
no
on a
friends?
Couple. I'm going to be on it, I think, in April.
Oh, you are? Good. Okay.
Well, you're not friends. I mean, maybe you are, but I was never. We were as
friendly.
Close as in L.A., but. Mm-hmm. He's a pretty reclusive cat, isn't
yes, he? Yes, he is. No, I mean, I think he was saying to me on the last time I did his show that he wants to get together.
Yeah, yeah, that you, you should try it again.
Why don't you try? You should call him on it.
Maybe I will. I don't know, but I haven't worked into it.
You haven't called.
He's as fucked up as I am.
Well, you're I mean, you have your close friends who you like, but you're pretty, you have to be reclusive. So do I.
I don't have to be. I just am.
But you are, right? So am I.
Why are you reclusive? Around.
Like, if huh?
Right,
if
I don't
want to go
be.
To Paris, for example, with my wife. I just went to Rome, all
right? Right.
Because I forgot to go on the honeymoon.
Yes?
I had a Conan shot, and I forgot the honeymoon. So I took her to Rome 3 weeks ago. I said, I forgot the honeymoon 3 years ago, and I'm sorry. So we went to Rome. What am I going to take Artie with me?
Were you miserable?
I would love to go.
Were you miserable in Rome? In other words,
had a great time.
You liked it. You're able to enjoy yourself with your wife. You're able to go places and not be afraid. Yeah. You're not going to die. The Holocaust is not going to happen.
Well, until they ask, when they ask me, you know, what's Artie Lang really like? That, you know, when I'm at the Coliseum.
I have family over there.
Why do you hate Arnold Schwarzenegger so much?
I don't really hate the guy, but I'm a Democrat.
I see. You don't like the way he's running California.
I don't give a fuck how he's running California. I just like, I'm a Democrat because I like African Americans, Latinos, and brown people.
You think he doesn't?
Not just, I don't know if he likes him, but I'm talking about the Republican Party, not him.
I see. So you're against him?
I'm against almost all Republicans, yeah, because I think it's all about white rich people getting richer and the poor and the middle class getting fucked.
Are you a Barack guy or a Hillary guy?
This time I'm holding out. I worked hard for the Clintons for 12 years.
Yeah.
But this time, I voted, but I don't want to stand next to anybody and lose anybody a vote. I want the White House to be Democratic, so I'm holding out until...
Who would you like to see in there more, Barack or Hillary?
I'm not saying that thing, because I don't want to hurt...
Why are you afraid? Because you have a preference.
I'm not afraid. I'll answer you.
Go ahead.
Because every time I would do photo ops with people, whenever you see a photo op with, like, a star...
It ruins
now,
it.
Anyone who hates... I'm a fucking very... like authentically nutcase, you know, like, so people go, I hate that fucking Jew.
You can
they
tell
won't
me,
vote for my person, so I don't want to lose any votes for Obama
you
or Clinton.
Tell me who you are personally
no, because millions of people hear you. I don't want people to go, Lewis likes him, I'm voting for
I
her.
Can tell
Lewis
you,
likes her, I'm voting for him. Really, people are that crazy.
People hate you that much that they would.
Some do, that's why I like my career. People either love me or hate me.
Can I tell you something?
Why, are you Bob Hope? You Bob Hope Stern?
No.
Of course not.
I'm Howard Stern.
That's right. So you're your own man.
And let me tell you something.
Artie Lang appeals to everybody.
I have no problem telling people I'm for Hillary Clinton. There it is. I just said
Do you
it.
Think you're losing her votes?
I don't know. Well,
that's my theory. I deserve that theory. I'm waiting.
I believe she'll be the nominee. Now, I'm starting to lose faith that she will be, but that'll
if
be
If she
it.
Becomes a nominee, or he does, I will kill myself for them to become president.
You want to end the war in Iraq, right?
There should never have been a war in Iraq.
Right.
It's a fucking joke.
Are you still addicted to phone sex?
Not as much anymore.
But you got an ear infection.
But what?
If my wife called me,
not as much.
Yeah. What do you? What do you?
You're still doing it?
I think I did it maybe once or twice.
Where do you do it? Do you call a service?
No, I don't call a fucking service.
Where do you have phone sex?
Like an ex-lover maybe, but I don't do it much
You're
anymore because I have my wife now.
Right, but
I save up my sperm
but once
now.
Did your wife get mad that you'll call an ex-lover every once in a while?
I don't. Though. I mean, I did it a couple early on in our relationship
before the marriage
because I was afraid to commit to one person. So I said, if I don't screw anybody, and you know, by the way, or making out. Or just jerk me off, I got to get out of here. You know, that's the same thing.
What would you
that's
do?
That's intimate.
Well, when you say addicted to phone sex, like...
Well, I used to be.
Were you very graphic?
I'll tell you why.
Yeah.
Let's say I'm in my house, and I have a concert and a tour coming up. When you come, in 6 seconds, whatever, however long, I never timed it. I'm not like a fucking... I don't wear a referee shirt when I jerk off.
The right, point right, is, right. Go ahead.
Once you come, you're fucking done. You can work on your material. You can go out and have a fucking risotto.
It relieves
Otherwise,
you.
I'm not 70 miles away with some circus clown in high heels. And I got to tell, listen, I don't really love you. I know I know we just fucked, but
not,
I don't.
I'm not putting
I don't
you
like,
down.
That's
I,
why
I understand.
That's why it's such a great thing.
All right, so you'd have the phone.
But it's harder to do it with a voice who you know
right.
than just yourself watching, you know, watching the news, eating pizza, jerking off in a hotel room.
Are
you feel like
very,
a fucking mental case.
Are you very liberated during phone sex? In other words, you can say anything to a woman?
No, it's totally selfish. I want to come, but I need...
But what do you need to hear?
Well, at the time when I did it, I wanted to feel connected to a woman because I didn't want to...
Was it sex talk or was she just talking?
I was a womanizer, so I gradually said, all right, I'm not going to go over the house
would you
and,
use, the
and
word,
use them.
Would you use the word cunt? In this,
no, I hate that word.
You do. Would
yeah,
you say
I love your pussy?
Would you say I love your pussy?
Oh, when I'm fucking? No,
no,
no.
When
you're having phone sex.
The phone sex.
Yeah, I'm pretty last hanging with Paris. I like dirty words, yeah.
You do. So you call up a girl and you say, oh,
well,
you're...
I wouldn't say this. I don't
I
like
love
that
your
word.
Pussy.
That's stupid. I would giggle over it. That's like a limerick.
You would? What would you want? What would you say? I can't imagine you naked on a bed but sprawled out with a phone.
Yeah, pretend we're making love.
No, put it on speaker.
All right, I'm the girl. You ready? Yeah. Here we go. Pretend. Yeah. Close your eyes.
Fuck me, you cunt. You fucker.
Oh, my cunt.
You pig fucker.
Oh.
You pig farmer.
Oh, okay.
Farmer.
Now I can see why you got turned on.
Oh, Last Tango in Paris. Rent the movie. It's fucking unbelievable. You pig fucker.
Well,
what's hotter than
something.
You pig fucker? It's Brando.
You know, a lot of people don't know this. You know who Richard Lewis banged? This will be.
Oh, come
is
on.
Anybody a fan of Deborah Winger?
Of course.
No one knows if I ever met. We went
I
out
do.
For a couple weeks.
Well, come on. What did you? What were you busy doing? You had sex with her.
I don't have any recollections 30 years ago.
Hello, Richard. This is Deborah Winger. Want to have phone sex
Do you
with
still call Deborah?
Are you on champagne?
Friends.
Have you seen her lately?
Are you on two glasses of champagne right now? I want you.
Let me tell you something. It was better fucking on when I did do drugs, on lewds and on booze than
yes.
on coke. On coke, my fucking penis turned into a fucking salmon.
Ever since you... I can't find the man who's had 22 MRIs. I love that. I'm trying to get him worked up.
You mean you don't do MRIs? You're a fucking germaphobe.
No, I don't do the MRIs.
He's even
no.
afraid
You're
of
crazy.
Those machines.
Those machines are
He's
dirty.
Afraid of German.
That's right. People are in those. Let's go to AA. AA, real quick. Go ahead. What's going on?
Put me down.
How's it going? What's going on? Well, I'm enjoying this interview very much. Welcome back, Richard. You're classic, bro.
Richard's
great,
the best.
Great fucking interview.
Thank you very
Thank you.
Much. Okay, let's go to Ken. That was AA. Go ahead, Ken, in Lighthouse Point.
One of the best interviews of all time. Hey, Richard, thanks for your honesty and all this. Season, what was it, 5 in Curb Your Enthusiasm with the whole kidney issue?
Yeah, I love that.
Yeah, season 5.
One of the
yeah, Howard wouldn't know, though.
I never saw it.
I know.
Great, great, great. Howard, you got to see it. More to the point. Fuck Bush. Thanks for your Democratic pushing. I mean, these guys got to be impeached.
Thank you very much. Let's go to Roy. Roy, go ahead.
Hello, hey now.
Hey now.
Oh, what's going on, guys? Good interview, Richard.
Thank you very
good
much.
Guys, the guys are kicking ass. What's up, Artie? How you doing?
What's up?
All right, thank you for
it's
the
about call. Richard
hold
today,
on,
sir.
Hold on, Suboxone. Suboxone, Artie. We love it, man. It's a shit.
Thank you. Stay on it.
I love it.
What
Have a good one, guys.
What Subutex.
Subutex.
Some people call it Suboxone.
Artie, do you sell your DVDs at the show and sit in the back at a table? And
I don't. I have a girl who does that.
That's so fucking embarrassing, man. You actually sell merchandise? Like,
no,
buy my DVD, you just saw me, and you can hear the same shit again?
Well, we're not all like you on anything but love. I mean, come on. The fuck? I got
yeah, that's funny. That was 20
money.
Years ago, you fucking mental.
Exactly.
Just be quiet. I'm here with... I haven't
well,
seen
don't
these guys
address
in 20,
me, then.
Three, well, just don't talk. Do a crossword puzzle. Jerk off. Get out of here. Take a shit. So, you know,
pitchers and catchers reported today. I got more important shit than listening to
when
you.
When I'm at comics this week, I'm talking about you all weekend.
Comics. I might show up and sell a place out for
you. If you show up, I'm going to fucking strangle your ass. Because you're going to just steal shit, man.
He's there to steal.
He's there to take material.
This guy came into the dressing room. He was very he said it was flattering.
I said, I could,
yeah,
it's on
you
tape.
Said the joke.
I could not have been more complimentary.
You shut up a minute. You said it exactly the way I said it, with right. my inflection, right. like as if you memorized. I have like 30 hours of fucking shit out there, and you probably know all of it.
I got the Odd Couple.
I'm getting your fucking
memorized, too. I don't steal from them.
Yes,
I,
you do.
I knew it that well, where I could do the whole
I knew the Odd Couple actors, and they fucking hate you.
What are you talking about?
Even
I,
the people
I'm
that do
here.
It in Summerstock hate
the,
you.
I
you
yeah.
do a piece of Richard's Listen, act? Go ahead.
I had the decency to tell him.
Yeah.
Last time he was here, I didn't get a chance to talk to him. But
right.
Richard has a special from 84-85 on Showtime.
Absolutely.
Honestly, it is the reason I wanted to become a stand-up comic.
Right.
And I heard him on your show. Every time he was on your show, I taped it. Every time he was
You're
on
You're making
Letter.
Him nervous. Look.
What is happening?
What's going on?
He
what
doesn't
happened?
Like this.
He's going to throw up. Why don't you like what Artie's saying?
He did this inside, too. He was squirming like a motherfucker.
You get uncomfortable with
I
this.
Don't trust it.
You think he's lying right now?
Yeah.
Why
is he
lying?
Because I don't trust comedians in general, because they steal.
I'm not a comedian.
You feel he's a...
What are you, a
so
butcher?
When he's telling you...
That's what I look like.
When he's telling
no,
you,
you
your material verbatim, you think, oh...
Well, when it's verbatim
yeah.
from a special, I'm in Pain, from 1985.
It's not I'm in Pain.
Then
it's the good one.
It was called I'm in Pain, and I did 7 of them, okay, you fucking moron?
The one on Showtime, the first one.
I'm in
one,
Pain. I know the name of my own special, you cunt.
The one from the improv in L.A. But, okay,
right,
no, so I, and then I told him, and I
right,
repeated
enough.
A couple. Want to hear the joke? I like.
Go ahead, let me hear the joke.
He's going to throw.
All right, here's Richard's
something.
Joke.
I'm
going to
blow at Artie.
Yeah, he really is nuts with this.
What is going on inside of you? Tell me. Do you think he's your mother?
You want Sal to come back in?
Oh, God.
This therapy thing. You
go
know,
ahead.
We can really be friends.
Right,
not that we're, you know, we're dying to be, but I do love you.
I
Are
love you.
Are you still in therapy? therapy? Are you still going as much as you used to?
Once a year.
Should Artie go to therapy?
Once a year?
Therapy?
Yeah.
You should be on a gurney now, first of all. Roll them to a fucking rehab.
All right, you know what?
24 really, hours.
Roll them in like really Frankenstein.
Fucking A.
This right. is really fascinating to me, because Greg from Howard TV had the camera on us, which was odd, but I barreled through, and I told him how much I loved him, and it was weird. He really
got uncomfortable.
Yeah, and I couldn't have been more complimentary. And even like I saw him at Carnegie Hall 20 years ago, and I told him,
look, he's getting upset
because of your show. I got Carnegie Hall, and I mentioned that on stage, and I saw Richard Lewis.
Well, Artie, thank you. I appreciate it.
What the fuck?
Because I've been fucked over by so many people. People like yourselves, and I trust you. All right? And I don't know you. Why should I trust you?
Oh my God.
So this is all bullshit.
This guy's a maniac.
Poor Artie.
Well, what? Should I?
I mean, no offense, but no offense.
Do you trust a virtual stranger?
I don't know what you're panicking about. That Artie is.
He's panicking that Artie has stolen his material.
Well, I don't trust people in general. I'm a paranoid guy.
No offense,
but you don't be so fucking.
Do you think this again?
No offense. I'm the one who's being weird now.
This goes.
I am. You're right.
This goes back to your mother. Again,
it goes back to
she didn't give you what you needed. You mistrust society. You mistrust people.
That's true.
Actually, like his mother?
I know an amazing story about his mother that he told on this show. That
easy,
it's true.
I'll leap over here and beat the shit out of
you. I know. You told this story
on
the show.
Go slow.
You remember that?
You're talking about someone who can't defend herself. She's gone.
It's going to be. You told this story, and I think it's very
telling.
See,
those are my fucking stories.
Yes.
What's my subconscious like, you prick?
I could act out The Godfather, too. It doesn't mean I steal from that. But he was on your
that
show.
That was fun.
Remember
write
the
it down.
The five comedians did that movie, the classic. I forget the name, but.
See, here's the kind of guy who likes to like bring
the
up
movie
over
with
a resume
Louis
of 35 years.
Right, yeah.
Howard, actually, Howard, Howard was on one of my specials, and he said something
it's
whatever you're going to say, he says, I can't remember, I'm doomed. I did that thing with Belzer and all those guys. We thought it was going to be funny. The movie wasn't that funny.
That one, that's the movie.
The Boy Scout movie. So Howard said on the special, I can't imagine a Boy Scout movie without Richard Lewis. That's a one-liner. What you're going to say is not that funny.
His actual mother did a guest starring thing in the movie.
That's true. She did. I tried. Okay. She did do something funny.
And there was a scene where, to me, this is telling. It would freak me out if my mom did this. You know, he's nervous. He's doing a film. He's a comic, not doing a lot of films.
How long is this anecdote going to last?
The mother is.
I haven't seen these people in 3 years, and you're doing my anecdote.
The mother's in a hole or something. He's got to pull her out of a dirt like ditch.
Right.
And he's trying to get into it. And he pulls the mother out, and she's wearing wardrobe that the movie bought her.
Right.
So as he's trying to stay in character and get his mother out of the ditch, his mother, while the camera's rolling, whispers to him, don't tug too hard. I want to buy this dress from the wardrobe.
That's funny.
And you told that story. It's not in bad light of your mom. I just think I could see how your mom might be a hellish memory.
Well, now you're making Richard sound unfunny.
There you go. Well, you know.
No.
You turned them off.
Let me do the one joke.
Hey, why don't you tell everybody what I had for breakfast last Thursday, you fucking idiot.
No offense, but what I'm saying is not exactly mainstream knowledge. I've watched you all.
So
who's asking
for mainstream fucking knowledge?
You should tell the story at the Borgata this weekend about Richard Lewis.
No, you know what? Don't come see me at the Borgata.
Yeah, close with the Blanche Lewis story in the fucking pond, you idiot.
You know what? I'm going to send all my comps over to the comics from the Borgata to sell it out.
I play the Borgata all the time, too. It's a great place, all right? So they're
going
to kick your ass if you kick my ass.
I'm going to say this joke.
This is a Richard Lewis joke.
My favorite. He said this on Letterman.
Okay, go ahead.
All right? And I'm going to try to do it.
He's killing me, this fucking guy.
Letterman goes, you know, like one of those fake setups. So you go to, I understand you're a big boxing fan. You just went to a boxing match. Yeah, I love boxing, but, you know, they stop the fights way too early now. You know, I don't want to see anybody get hurt. But, I mean, come on, let them fight a little bit. I was on a boxing match last week. A guy gets tapped in the head. The referee goes up to him and says, who's Fred Travellina? I don't know. It's over.
that was a joke I did, yeah.
Yeah, right. So, and I do that for him. I don't know. If I was I'm a comic.
So I hope it works for you at the Borgata this weekend.
As a comedian, that would be nice for me.
So you don't like that Artie came up and told an anecdote?
No, I don't take compliments, Paul. That's really what
shit.
All right. Well, listen, Artie's taking up all your time. We have to say goodbye.
I'm sorry, Richard. You didn't get to tell any stories.
Right. I'm sorry, Richard.
That's all right.
God.
I got to go prepare for my gigs anyway. I haven't been, because I had the hernia operation, so I got to, you know.
You're a little rusty.
Let me tell you how good it is to see you. You're funny. You're on top of your game. I see what's going on.
I think you're enjoying life a little more now.
I love life. I love stand-up. I can't take compliments. Well, I already proved that pretty well.
Yeah, I guess.
Fred sabotaged me like the old days. I love that. Well, hey, Artie, the accountant guy came in. He's you know, that's not scared me.
Artie, we only have a couple more seconds. Can you do some of the material from Date from Hell? The jokes.
By the way, it's great to see Richard invented the From Hell thing that everybody stole.
It's in the Yale Book of Quotations.
I don't believe that.
He said he invented the From Hell thing.
My parents always said From Hell.
From me. From 30 years ago. It's in the yearbook. Oh, who gives a shit? Good to see you.
No, Richard.
No, I remember you always said
thanks
that.
Thanks for having me.
Are you healthy enough now that when I call you, you will not just hang up, you will be able to say goodbye?
I'm a totally different man. Okay. My wife changed my life. And it's
all what recall, is that all about?
I recall having phone conversations with you where you would not say goodbye. You would just hang up.
Really? No, I do that because I like to get off on a laugh. That's the reason.
But
and
it's
so
a phone
you just
call.
Hang up.
But it's because of being a comic, since I'm 22, that's what it is. It's just a psychological defect.
Right. Listen to me. You're doing well. Yeah. God bless you. This show, Curb Your Enthusiasm, you're on. Everyone loves it. Tomorrow night, everyone is going to go see you. Tomorrow night and Saturday night at Comics, C-O-M-I-X, in Manhattan. For tickets, go to comicsny.com, comicsnewyork.com. Richard's book, which is really a revealing look into the mind of a comic.
And if you read it, there's a lot of drugs in there.
If I already have the book, will they sell me just the last 4.5 pages?
Richard, is there any chance of that? Okay. Richard's book. Well, why don't you just go to the store?
Call the reissue, you fucking jerk off.
Richard's book, The Other Great Depression, will be reissued on March 17th with a new afterward. And as Artie points out, it's 4.5 pages. You may go to the store and just read the 4.5 pages. And Richard's documentary, Richard Lewis Naked, is available.
Marks.
What?
Yeah, Michelle Marks is the film.
All right, we don't know who that is. Richard Lewis Naked is available at richardlewisnaked.com. I love this
I don't
guy.
Get a dime from it. It's just a good film.
And you're going to get my phone number, and I want you to give it to Ron Wood and have him call me.
You go out to dinner, you and your fiance and Ronnie and his
wife. I would like to be with Ronnie and his
wife. I don't need to be there.
Yeah, if you don't mind.
I'll pimp
please
for
him. Please pass my number.
I'll pimp for you. I know a lot of people.
No. I'm going to give you my number. I would like it if you'd call me for next week so I can have dinner.
I'm coming back in April to do the Y with Keith Olbermann.
Well, April,
me.
I'm booked up, but I would be.
Oh, man. See, I smell it. I smell a fucking rat.
I'm talking about this time.
I'm available.
I'm going to take you and your wife. I'm going to take you and your wife out to dinner. That's all. Right. I'm offering. Right. You want to get together or not?
But I'm only in for a few days. I'm on tour.
Well, how many days do we need? I mean, what are you talking about?
What do you mean you're booked up in April? I'm here for 10 days in April.
April, I'm not here. I can't see you in April.
He's taking off the whole month.
I'm gone.
Get out of here.
That's it. I'm leaving town.
I'm going to fucking camp out. I'm camping out.
I love you. I really love you.
I thought of the better way to tell that story from the movie.
Do it in your fucking dreams.
No, in April I fast. So I don't eat dinner. Richard Lewis is the greatest, and you have to see.
We're still on, Richard. You can't throw down.
He's the greatest,
like,
and he gets uncomfortable when I say that.
I mean, my God.
Look at that wedding ring. Wow. All right.
If you see him, don't say you like him know a joke is.
He lost a lot of weight. Very thin. All right, we're going to be back right after these words.
And now, the good reverend delivers us words of love and compassion.
The devil is a motherfucking liar. So you know I ain't worried, biatch. Stupid bitch. Look at that. I'm provoking that, huh? That I'm making motherfuckers just hate God more. I'm provoking that, huh? You goddamn devil worshiper, you ain't got no excuse. Motherfucker, you ain't coming in you come in the name of Satan. I guess if you like a house nigga and won't go competitive, if I say I'm God, then I guess you have to take the side of Satan, huh, motherfucker? Stupid bitch. It's not of competition, it's of cooperation. Stupid ass house nigga. I can't see you though, bitch. You see me? I'm all out. I make my ass very available. Tom, next caller.
Be free. And you're listening to The Howard Stern Show.